Just this morning, there is a new interview with President Obama released by the Associated Press. And I want to take a listen just for a moment here to the president talking about the fact that this shutdown is not just about this moment, but it's also about the looming debt crisis.
There are enough votes in the House of Representatives to make sure that the government reopens today. And I'm pretty willing to bet that there are enough votes in the House of Representatives right now to make sure that the United States doesn't end up being a deadbeat.
Okay, so this question of deadbeat has to do with raising the debt ceiling. Speaker Boehner has continuously indicated he's not going to allow default. But if we don't get this dealt with, are we going to bump up against that debt ceiling conversation?
We absolutely are. And the big talk right now is that one of the reasons the shutdown is expected to go on a while is that it seems inevitable we're going to have to resolve these two things at once. Mm-hmm. It's going to have to get far enough that Boehner can talk about these two things as one issue and mm-hmm. say, okay, we have this October 17th deadline, which is what the Treasury has named for default, mm-hmm. and we have this ongoing shutdown. Let's talk about them both. But the situation is in some ways exactly the same, which is that the White House refuses to even consider negotiating on the debt ceiling.
Yeah.
It's something they have to do. And since Boehner says we're never going to default, what's the motive to give any concessions? Either you believe this is going to destroy the economy or you don't. And if you do believe it's going to destroy the economy, what's your leverage? No one wants that.
Right. And he has to hang tough now because, you know, yes. liberals and progressives absolutely want that. People recognize that this is causing, you know, as the ripple effect continues, it is causing pain to people. But remember, ask anyone in law enforcement, what's the rule when you have a hostage situation? Drop the gun, release your hostage, you know, put down that bomb. And then we will talk. He cannot, you know, be led down that path again. And I do think he has finally learned the lesson with this totally unreasonable caucus.
And Raul, so on the one hand, there's this fundamental question about governing that you're mm-hmm. pointing out here, right? And the fact that we cannot negotiate with people who are holding the government hostage. On the other hand, there is kind of nastier underbelly to this, and that is there are some folks winning as a result of this shutdown. We're just looking at the DNC and the GOP fundraising numbers, Bob.
Right.
And you've got the DNC raising slightly less than $850,000 from 30,000 donors in the first 24-hour period leading up to the shutdown. And you've got the Republican National Committee claiming that it did even better, raising $1 million in just less than 48 hours from Monday to Wednesday. Even as we are about to go bump up against this debt ceiling, are the parties winning as they are positioning themselves in
well,
all of this?
There's a bit of wisdom in politics that when it comes to fundraising, losing is winning. Mm. And right now you have both sides really up in arms right now and able to go out there and excite their people into giving some money, mm-hmm. that kind of thing. So, yeah, there are any number of winners, and there are also going to be some political winners in all this. One other point. I think what we're seeing is a classic hard-nosed negotiation, the kind of mm-hmm. thing you see when there is a labor strike or something like this. And the administration right now has the tactical advantage. I think that when President Obama, called that meeting at the White House, the main reason for that was to get the hopes up of the Republicans that mm-hmm. he was going to stop rubbing their faces in it and all of that. Then nothing happened, and so it really just sort of played with their heads. Mm-hmm. I think finally what's going to happen, whether it happens immediately or whether it happens in mid-October, there's going to be the search for some sort of face saver, some sort of way mm-hmm. to play cognitive dissonance, stop being the nasty guy and giving them something that they can claim as a victory, they being the Republican.
Well, and this notion of face saving in hardline negotiations where there's mm-hmm. a lot on the line is normally what we're talking about when we're doing international relations, right? This is normally what you have to do when you're right. dealing with the head of another state, right. another government, and you've got to give them some room. And we actually have just seen President Obama managed with some deftness that question of Syria when it felt like everybody was boxed in and there were no exit strategies.
Right.
In fact, generating some exit strategies and some alliances with people like Putin, who you wouldn't think those alliances would be possible. Do you think that is possible here in the domestic context? Can we get a Putin to help us out? A domestic Putin,
Sure, but you know, I just have to say, even if it is a small concession, why should they get any concession mm-hmm. for basically upending the governance? Mm-hmm. I think that still sticks in the craw of many, you know, on the Democratic side. It's just so unreasonable. Even if it's a small thing, it's not cool.
No domestic Putin helping. Up next, protests are scheduled to begin in less than 2 hours all around the country. Believe it or not, these are not protests about the government shutdown.